Hey folks, welcome back to Nerding Down the Creek. I took a little week off. I was trying to grow my hair out and I didn't want to ruin the surprise for the video, you know. So this is happening right now. All right, so I wanted to talk about today's workout, the bouncy ball. A little intention, a little execution, and then maybe a little metaphor of what this one is like. So in the write-up, it talks about how it's a great opportunity, medium long, right? It's over 15 minutes, but it's under 20. It's kind of that weird place. Do I go fast? Do I pace? Do I sprint? Like, what do I do? And it's an AMRAP, meaning if you go out too fast, too early, you could hide and not move a whole lot. The clock's gonna keep ticking. You're not gonna get any work done, but hey, workout ends at 16 minutes. So well done. You didn't get as fit as you possibly could. So how do we counteract that? Well, this one is all about treating it in what I would argue kind of like a three-act play. So act one, exposition, is that first part where it's really kind of the first five, six-ish to about 8 minutes. It's about the first half is act one, where if you come out too hard, you're gonna hit that metabolic catastrophe. You're not gonna be able to keep that pace. You're gonna slow way down. And yeah, you maybe have done those first couple rounds kind of fast, but then everything's gonna slow way down. A lot of standing around, not a whole lot of work being accomplished. It's kind of like a play, or kind of like that first act of a story or of a movie where if they give you too much too early, the nudity, the comedy, the violence, whatever, you're kind of like, eh, you're exhausted by the middle of the movie. You're like, I don't really care about this conflict anymore. I don't even really care about the story. I've kind of fallen asleep. And then when it all happens and it all kind of goes the way you expect it to go, you're like, eh, wasn't that great? So act one, part one, exposition, figure your shit out. Pacing, breaking up strategy. Be overly conservative. Keep a lot back. Wait to release some of that speed that you know is in there until act two, which is our rising action, where the end of act two is kind of that climax. You want that to happen kind of that 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, maybe even to like the 14 minutes. So let's say in the first seven and a half minutes, I get three rounds. Well, then my goal would be by like 14-ish, I wanna have done another three rounds. This would be the part where you start to build pace. Maybe if you were going like 4-4-4 in the wall ball, you go 6-6. Maybe if you were breaking up the handstand pushups early, you start doing bigger sets. Maybe you pick up the pace on the burpees just a little bit. Maybe you cut down on some of that rest in the transitions. You find places to be a little bit more efficient. Don't make the movements that much faster. Just be more efficient in your rest and your transitions. All to set up that final sprint or act three, our denouement, the resolution. This is where no matter what you've done up to this point, everybody can sprint for the last 90 seconds or so. And that's what you want to do in this one is be conservative early, hit the middle section with a little bit more aggressiveness to put you in a position to really sprint the end. If you come out at a pace, let's say you're shooting for six rounds. If you come out at a pace at six plus rounds, you will be lucky to get six rounds. You'll probably be lucky to get five because you're gonna hit the middle, you're gonna start resting way too much. This one is about being patient. Act one, exposition, take your time. Let the story develop. Don't rush it. Take a little bit more rest than you think you need. Act two, let that conflict start to rise. Get a little bit heated, pick up the pace. Bigger sets, less stress. All to set up that act three, which when it's done, you're on the floor, you're exhausted, you never thought you could do that. You're so happy, you're excited, well done. Because in our metaphor, we have our epilogue, which is the mobility. 3 to 4 minutes up against the wall, couch stretch for 30 seconds on each leg, 30 seconds of child's pose, 30 seconds of arm under, 30 seconds of arm under. You're right as rain, go do your weekend. All right, have fun, we'll see you on and off the creek. Get after it. Adios.